Dear friends, praise the Lord. It's such a great honor to come again and speaking to you. And please kindly watch our videos and subscribe. And you can join in our ministry and you can help whatever the way you can help for our ministry. Today, I just wanted to share about a small thought which God has given to me. Do we have praying friends? Do we have ministry friends? Do we have godly friends? If you have godly friends, your life will be godly. Your life will be fruitful. Your life will be going in a different direction, which can take you nearer to Jesus Christ. There we can see Acts chapter 3 verses 3. Peter and John, they went to temple to worship the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, today I just wanted to share about this word. Peter and John, they are going to temple to pray. So we all know this this scripture and this verse very, very well. Acts chapter 3 verses 3, there we can see they healed lame man, and they healed him, and that all the miracles happened in their ministry as they are walking towards temple. So, my dear friends, what I wanted to say is, Peter and John, they're going to temple to pray. Do you have a friend who can pray with you? Do you have a friend who can join with you in your ministry, in your prayers? We can see in the world, if you call any of your friends, they will come for food. They will come for time pass. In the world, they can go to cricket, or they will go to some cinemas or worldly things or whatever, however they wanted to spend some time with you, they will spend. But here I'm telling you, as a God's children, do you have praying friends? Do you have worshiping friends? Do you have singing friend along with you? If you have praying friend, if you have a ministry partner faithfully, you will see great things happening in your life. There we see Acts chapter 11 verses last word. If you see from if you read from Acts 11th chapter 20:15 to 12:13-14, like that, if you go there, you can see Paul and Barnabas. You will find them. They supported to the other ministries and the other people. They sent by God, and they were together, and they are finding each other, and they are going and doing great works for the glory of God. My dear brothers and sisters, today I wanted to tell you, if you are missing, if you go somewhere, do you have a very good friend who can find you? Do you have good friend who can pray for you? If you go to other ministry, if you go to other place, if you go for God's work or any of your personal need, do you have a friend who can, encourage you with the word of God, who can minister with you, who can support you, who can pray with you? In these days, it's very, very essential. We are in ending days. We should have a praying friends. We should have a ministry partners. We should have a godly friends, however, whatever it may be. If you call, anybody will come for any other kind of, situation, or if you want them to come, they will come. But if you ask them for prayer, will they come? It is very important. It is very necessary for you. Praying friends is very, very important. So if you don't have a praying friend, you will lose something which is very unique in the sight of God. And you cannot even pray. Sometimes you cannot pray. Sometimes you cannot share the God's word. Because sometimes you cannot open your heart and speak to everybody. So you should have very good friend. If you should have very, faithful friend, there are times, you are thinking that he is the person, she is the person who loves me so much, who is very friendship with me, who wants to come to me every time. But what happened at the last moment? For financially, or if you say any kind of word harshly or rushingly, or however, if they're doing something wrong, you may correct them. Many of the reasons they might have broken in your friendship. But I wanted to tell you today, have good friendship, have godly friendship, have a strong connection. Simply just for fun and just for time pass, friends, you don't need for us. Have and select a good person who can stand with you in all times, who can help you in all time, who can encourage you in all time, who can pray with you in all times, my dear brothers and sisters. It is very important. It is very important. Share with them and pray with them and, you know, talk to them with the word of God and speak to them with the word of God and encourage them. You encourage them for their ministry, for their works, for their personal needs, and they will also encourage you and support you for your personal needs. But I wanted to tell you today, it is very important, as we are ministers of God, as we are the children of God, as we are believers of Christ, we should have a godly friendship. Don't mingle with everybody. You are chosen and you are special. You are called to be blessed and you are not an ordinary person. You are extraordinary in the sight of God. That's why you should have a powerful friend. You should have a godly friend. If you ask somebody for prayers, somebody will not agree. Why? Because their standards are low. Their prayer life is low. But whenever you ask, if your friend is praying with you, he is the right person for you. If you ask anytime your friend to come along with you to the temple, to God's temple, to the church, if he comes or if she comes, he is the correct person for you. He is the correct friend for you. My dear brothers and sisters, God's word says, real friend never leave you. So my dear brothers and sisters, I don't know whom you are watching and you know what kind of you know situations you are going through, what kind of problem you are going in. You might have broken from your friendship, or you know, maybe some people might have cheated you. But today I want to tell you, have a God's friendship, have a godly man and godly woman in your life. They will help you. They will pray with you, my dear brothers and sisters. So there you see, John and Peter, they went to temple together. Go with your friends together. Go with your friends together to the temple of God, to the church. So for everything they will come, for every kind of, world things, are just for time pass, people will come, people will speak, people will call. But when you need, very important, when you need for your personal prayer life time, they will never come. Praying time, they will never come. So my dear brothers and sisters, have godly friendship and have a good friend, select the good friends, and don't mingle with everyone. And you are called to be blessed. You are a different person. You are chosen, and God want to do something with you and your family, and you are really a blessed person. So do you have praying friend? If you don't have praying friend, select it today and pray together for the first time. And every time now and then pray, and you will see great things happening. That is why in Acts chapter 3 we see miracles happen, because they were praying, and they are prayerful people. And there you see in Acts chapter 11 also you see Paul and Barnabas, they were prayerful, and they always go and search for each of them if they are missing, or if they are in the ministry, if they are going in different parts of the world, they are talking each other. However, they are meeting now and then. So such a way, if you are also going somewhere, your friend should call you. Your friend should help you and pray for you and find you. That is very important. If we are going somewhere, if you are not having any support, people will leave you. But such kind of friends we don't need. But I want to tell you today, have godly friendship. God bless you, my dear brothers and sisters. Godly friends, arrange God's godly friends, select godly friends, pray for your friends. God will give you, and God will bless you to be a great blessing for the world. Amen. Praise the Lord.